In today's video, I am going to explain important anatomical landmark around shoulder. Today's point is about here. This is around posterior part of axilla and shoulder. Actually, there's no such a name around this area. Let's say this is posterior axilla. This is freaking important place. You see, many muscles are crossing around this area. So if this part gets tight, that can affect for many muscles. This is like a terminal of muscles. Does it make sense? It's important to focus on this area. You can apply today's anatomy for therapeutic circumstance and for yoga, Pilates, self-care treatment, and for athletic performance. Okay, let me explain what kind of muscles there are. First one is this one. This is deltoid. Deltoid, particularly posterior fiber. Posterior fiber of deltoid. Next one is this one. This is triceps brachii. Triceps brachii. Next one is this one. This is latissimus dorsi. Latissimus dorsi. This one is teres major. Teres major. By the way, latissimus dorsi and teres major do completely identical movement. That means these guys can do same movements. It's gonna be important. I will talk about this thing later. Okay, above teres major, there's small muscle compared to teres major. So this is teres minor. Teres minor. And last one is this one. This is infraspinatus. Infraspinatus. See, a lot of muscles are crossing around this area. Again, when this part gets tight, that affects for many muscles, don't you think? So this is very important place. Now, tendency of these muscles are that they do adduction, except deltoid. Other muscles do adduction of shoulder joint. Adduction is you close arm this way. This is adduction. One more tendency. They tend to do shoulder extension. By the way, adduction and extension. Extension is you bring arm backward. Let's say triceps brachii. This guy does adduction and extension. Latissimus. It does adduction extension. Teres major, same as latissimus dorsi. See, and deltoid posterior part, this guy does extension. So they tend to do adduction and extension. So what happens if this part gets tight? Let me talk about that. This is abduction position of shoulder. Abduction is this way. This is abduction. And muscles are running like this. So many muscles are running on posterior axilla, right? What is tendency? What kind of movements they do? They do adduction, right? This is adduction. You wanna do abduction, but what happens if posterior axilla gets tight? These muscles try to pull arm this way, thus, you cannot go full abduction for 180 degrees. This is so common that when you have tightness around here, abduction is restricted. This is freaking important. Tremendously important place for shoulder joint. Tendency is abduction is inhibited. Then one more movement. What kind of movement do they do? They do extension. Let me talk about that. This is profile view of abduction position. So when this part gets tight, they tend to bring shoulder to extension. Imagine this, there's major latissimus dorsi, deltoid posterior fiber, like this. So when you do abduction, like this, tendency is that your shoulder kind of goes forward. You cannot raise up arm like vertically. Image is your arm goes toward face, towards nose, towards, you know, anterior way. This is tendency because this muscle tries to pull shoulder this way. Thus, it goes forward. See, it's very important. This area. And where is that exactly? Where can you find this place and how can you apply for self-care treatment and yoga and practice? Let me explain that. Here is tip. You know, when you wear shirt, there is stitches on middle part of axilla and ribcage, right? Like this. And there is stitches around axilla, like this, right? Then that place is a bad meeting point of stitches, like that. When you raise arm like this, when you do abduction, and the location is where stitches meet. This is about general area of that posterior axilla. This place, I have to say that again. The place is where stitches meet, like this, around this area. So in this area, there is latissimus dorsi, triceps brachii, deltoid posterior fiber, teres minor, infraspinatus stress major. Many muscles are around this area. Maybe it's slightly behind from this meeting point of stitches, but it's about this area. Okay, this is how you find this posterior axilla point. Now you know where that is. So how can you stretch out? How can you do self-treatment for this busy, important area? Where is that place again? Stitches of shirt is about here, the middle part of clothes. And imagine this person wears shirt like this, stitches about here. The place is about here, or a little bit posterior from meeting point. Then there are latissimus dorsi, teres major, triceps brachii, so many muscles. How can you stretch that place out? One thing is you do side bend stretching, side body stretching. This stretch stretches out these muscles. Why? Because these muscles try to pull arm this way. So you do opposite movement. You do shoulder abduction. Okay. Now you know where that is and you have visualization of anatomy. If you have clear visualization in your head, so the efficiency of stretching, efficiency of yoga and athletic performance increases like boom. It's like skyrocket. Having clear vision of anatomy is freaking important. In this video, I explained important shoulder anatomy. It's posterior axilla. There are numerous muscles crossing around this area. So stretching around this area or doing treatment this area is very important. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment and subscribe. See you next video.